So what, obviously, what was your reading of which way it's blowing?
Yeah, so I think that Uttar Pradesh, as you well know, is a very sort of caste-dominated state. And yet, I was also surprised this time, even though we all know that, just how strong the caste lines in Uttar Pradesh are. So it's like, you know, there is no issue anymore. As we were discussing that, we want to believe here in the urban setting that India is moving to a post-caste world, right? That's what we want to believe. Uttar Pradesh tells you that in this trip, at least, that we move to a post-truth world. And I'll tell you what I mean by this. That in Uttar Pradesh, all you need to do is to ask a person's name and surname. And 99% of the time, you will be able to predict which way this person is going to vote. So if it's a Brahmin or a Thakur or a Baniya, that person is voting the BJP. Similarly, if the person is a non-Yadav OBC, that person is voting the BJP. And even among the scheduled castes, if it's outside of Mayawati's subcaste of Jatavs, like, you know, like Parsis, etc., they're all voting the BJP. That's one side. On the other side, the Yadavs, the Muslims, the Jatavs, very large chunks of the vote base, they're all voting for the Mahagathbandhan, is what they'll tell you. So ask the surname, and if you can guess from the surname what's the caste, you can guess without asking them as to which way they're voting. Then there is the second issue, which is that you ask them, why are you voting for this party, right? Which is the logical question to ask. So it's like people on this side, if you take the BJP, they will check off the box and quote to you the same 4 to 5 reasons why they're voting for the BJP, that they provided you more toilets, Izzat Ghars as they call them, they provided better roads, electricity, and that you need a strong leader like Modi at this point in time, you know, like to help secure the nation. That's what you'll get from this crowd. Now the other crowd, they will tell you exactly the opposite, which is that we have got nothing from the government, the toilets may have been built, but there's no water connection to them, we're using them to store our grains, you know, and there's a lot of corruption which is still happening. They'll point to you, they'll actually tell you that there's no electricity out here. So somebody is telling you that now we get great electricity, the other side is telling you we get no electricity. So it is like there are no facts anymore. It is what you make of the facts. So that's what I found really amazing, that by the end of the trip, mine was forget it. There's no point asking in terms of which way are you going to vote. All you need to know is the surname. And here's the problem, which is that if you look at the last election also, the BJP's vote share is exactly the same or roughly the same as the vote share of the Mahagathbandhan. The only difference is that the Mahagathbandhan this time has tied up. Last time they hadn't tied up. And this complete transfer of votes going on, which is that we went to a Mayawati rally. A lot of Samajwadi party workers are fully there. So that's why this election for me has become so hard to call, because it is exactly 50-50 in the largest state like UP. It's just split completely down the middle.